Good day everybody, this is Doppel of Doppel Gameplay Videos, and today I bring to you a console so illegal that Nintendo launched a multi-million lawsuit against people selling it in the United States. Armed FBI agents raided the Mall of America searching for this console to seek and destroy every single unit in existence. And back when I was a kid in the early 2000s, this was my main console. This was the console I played on all the time. Of course, I am talking about the Power Player Super Joystick and Power Gun. Now, this is a rare surviving console from the early 2000s, and it's in such good condition that even the original box was preserved. Look at that, it even says Y2K. Anyway, let's do turn the box around, and oh man, this brings back memories. I remember Christmas of 2001, I unboxed one of these and I was so happy. It costed me $20 from the thrift store, which is way too expensive for what you're getting these days. And unfortunately, it's missing the power gun. The power gun looks like this. It actually looks like this. It doesn't even have the orange safety tip. It actually looks like a real gun. So I'm guessing that's why they disposed of it. So what this is basically a Nintendo Entertainment System crammed into a small chip inside. And inside is pirated copies of copyrighted games. So this was committing massive copyright infringement. That's why there was a massive crackdown against this console. So I really do hope that this thing still works, because I have not tested this. And I remember as a small kid, I played on this console for an entire summer. Well, not really entirely summer. Half the time of my summer breaks were playing this console, and half I was biking around the mountains with my friends. Those days were the best. But anyway, let's go unbox this really rare surviving console. This was imported by a company called PGDTOR, which I can't even find online. I guess they went under. And it originally retailed for $70. Yeah. Before the Nintendo Entertainment System Mini was produced, this was the de facto way of playing old Nintendo games. So let's go unbox it and see what we get. Let's go remove the price tag rubber band, $20. And then let's go open it right here. Oh my gosh, I'm not sure what these black bits are. Oh man, this really brings back memories of Christmas of 2001. Oh man, what is breaking apart in here? Oh, there's this black plastic everywhere. Okay, so let's see. Up here is the console itself, and yeah, that feels absolutely cheap plastic. The D-pad is terrible, the buttons are okay, reset button, and this analog stick doesn't even move. There's a power switch here, power input, audio and video outputs, and of course they're being corroded, second joystick and gun. Ah, here is how it's powered. So pressing this button will release this cartridge, and then in this cartridge you're supposed to add batteries. How do you... Aha, there. Four batteries, and then that produces enough power to power this console. And as a kid, I actually accidentally put it like this and it jammed itself. That was not a pleasant experience. Yeah, console-wise, it feels really bad. The plastic is very cheap, very nasty. What else do we get? Cables, audio cables. Yeah, sure, I'd use that. And here's the original video cables it came with. Really flimsy and nasty. And the second player controller. Oh, that sucks. Usually they have a little screw insert here that allows it to be played like a joystick. A, B, and C buttons, start button. Cable is really feels bad and it's cheap. I mean, that's where the plastic is coming from. This power adapter has been completely destroyed. This is absolutely dangerous to use. And I can definitely see that they cheapened... Oh, the plastic is crumbling as I touch it. They definitely cheapened out on creating this power adapter. The transformer doesn't look great. The secondary windings look absolutely horrible. Simple full bridge rectifier and a capacitor. Very basic. I give this an F-. This does not have the modern safety of proper wall warts. Needed outputs, 9V DC. Oh man, this thing is just crumbling. Okay, I'm gonna go dispose of this before it pollutes my room. Oh man, the smell! The smell of plastic is permeating. I'm gonna go get rid of this shredded plastic that's atomizing as I touch it. Oh, it's kind of a shame that we didn't get a power gun. The cheap cables could go back as well. Yeah, kind of a shame that we didn't get a power gun. It would have been interesting to look at. But at the same time, it does look like a real gun, so I can understand why they got rid of it. Of course, being an illegal product, they didn't follow safety regulations. This plastic is probably poisonous. Let's put this away. Let's put down a heavy layer of disinfectant right there. Oh, man. I'm running my air filter right now. That's why there's the whooshing sound. Oh, the smell is intense. It's like cheap China plastic. You know the smell when you've smelled it. Oh. All right, I'm back. Here we go. I've disinfected the console, and now we're just ready to power it on. All right. It's plugged in. Everything seems to be set up, and I'm going to be turning it on in 3, 2, 1, go. Why the heck is there a Teletubby there? Look at all those sprites. It's like badly colored. It's so pixelated. Anyway, let's go press the start button. Okay. Let's see. Contra. We got World Sucker. Super Mario. Anyway, let's see what we have. We got Contra. Tekken. Pretty sure that is pretty sure that's mislabeled. Bomb Jack, I remember playing that a lot. Helicopter, yes, Sky Destroyer. Let's just play a random game. I can't believe as a kid I actually spent hundreds of hours on this console. Let's start with Gold Classic Contra. So far, it actually looks pretty spot on. And back then, when I... Let me just turn it down. And back where I lived, consoles like this cost about 100 pesos, which is about $2. And for that price, you're getting like 76 actual full-bore Nintendo games. And the quality isn't so bad. This D-pad sucks, though. Okay. Oh, I can't play Contra anymore. I used to beast this game when I was a kid. Okay, so there's actually four buttons. One of them is a rapid fire button, which you can just hold, because press and hold, and then it will just rapid fire everything. No! Oh. That's the show that as you grow up, you start to suck. Okay, that works. Push start button. How about night? What is night? Oh. This is one of those Chinese original games which suck. My ears are bleeding. Nope, I can't figure out that game. World Sucker. Oh, it's Nintendo Sucker. Next. King of Fighter. Yeah, it's DR Kung Fu. How about Tekken? What is Tekken? Oh, it's Karateka. And of course, the best way to play this is just to fall backwards and die. Best way to play that game is to fall backwards and die. Nope. Tetris 2. Oh, this is Tangent's Tetris. It's actually a decent version of Tetris for the Nintendo. Oh wow, there's no sliding. Once it touches the floor, it locks in. Okay, let's see. Oh, I misjudged that. Thank you for having no ghost pieces. Just spoiled with like modern Tetris. Oh, come on. Yay, we cleared the line. Next. Let's see. Arkanoid. I'm pretty sure I know how Super Mario plays. Okay, it's running slower than normal. You can tell that by how all the sounds seem to be lower pitched. Yeah, next. Arkanoid. Oh yeah, it's this game. Actually beaten this game now that I think of it. The lack of analog control for these kind of games on the Nintendo is it's really hard. Next. 1942 is probably that that Capcom shooter game. Yeah, next. Pac-Man, probably the Namco NES port. Yeah, it was. Okay, this D-pad sucks. Okay, let's go eat a ghost and die. What the heck? I'm actually trying to die here. There we go. Next. Let's see. Stargate. Shooter game. Super Mario Brothers. Binary Land. Oh, I remember this game. So, in this game you play as two penguins at the same time and your controls are mirrored. And your goal is to actually get them to meet in the middle. Okay, let's go up here. It's kind of a challenge to get your characters to meet together like this. There we go. Nice. Of course, you gotta watch out for, spider webs. This was easier than I remember. Okay, we should grab the other penguin down there. Okay, come on, go, 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 go. We want to get a whale. Oh, that's super speed. Nice. Perfect! 50,000 points. A lot of this, most of this game probably comes down to you paying attention to both halves of the screen. What does the umbrella do? Oh, it's gone! Gotta get rid of those spiders. Ah, I want to get the whale. Do I want to get the whale? No, of course it's gone so quickly. Okay, this is gonna be a bit weird because now there's no straight shot to get together. Oh no, that's fine. No, what the? Oh, we have to be really specific, do we? Okay. Go down. There we go. Nice. I never actually got this far back when I was a kid. Okay, now let's just die. Let's see. Circus Charlie. Oh, this game is so BS because of how irritating it is. Okay, so you play as this clown guy, and you have to do various circus stunts, and they get ridiculous later on. And the hitbox is also very unusually large, from what I remember. Yeah! Okay, good. The hitbox is also unusually large from what I remember, and it's easy to die. I do remember getting as far as the horse bouncing stage. I'm gonna see if I can actually get to that point. But yeah, this game is mostly ridiculous. And surprisingly, I've watched somebody LP it on YouTube. They cleared it in just 10 minutes. Oh, I got roasted. Nope, next. Let's see. Sporten and PN? I don't remember that game. Oh no, this is that game where you have to Yes, I'm ready. This is that game where you have to go past this entire room and then have all enemies coming at you from all directions. Okay, we gotta kick. What the heck? Okay, I'm currently pinned down right here. Okay, I'm gonna close in. Ah! Come here so I can kick you in the face. Come on. Okay. Ah, I'm pinned down. I can't move. Gotcha. Okay. Am I supposed to be going left? Ah, oh, that hurts. No! No! Okay, I'm supposed to go left. Go on. How did I not discover this game? Maybe this game wasn't in my power player back when I was a kid. This is fun as heck. No. I'm pinned down again with this silly knife thrower. Ah, he moved backwards. This D-pad is not conducive to a good game experience. No! Of course. That is ridiculous. How do you even get past that? Okay, so jumping requires you to hold upwards, and to jump upwards and forwards, you need to hold the diagonal. And this D-pad is so bad that I can't even... No! I can't get a solid diagonal action. My thumb is straining now from using this D-pad. Come on, we can do it. No! Oh, I got stabbed. That is ridiculous. I actually might want to play this on an emulator. So I'm not constrained with a silly D-pad. Most of these games don't hold up today. Star Destroyer. No. Sky Destroyer. I do remember this one. It's one of the first 3D-ish games that I played, but no, it's actually just 2D. Splash! Combat, let's try that. Oh, Field Combat, I remember this one. You play as this UFO thing, and you're trying to invade this field, and it's actually a non-lethal combat exercise, because It seems to be some sort of pretend military exercise. People pretend to actually die when they get hit, but they actually go back upwards crying. Okay, this helicopter, I remember this being a pain in the butt to actually aim for. As you notice, there's a very fixed range of where the projectile actually explodes. And to hit anything, you must predict. No, a miss! You must predict where the bomb will actually go. And these flying enemies, they move so fast and so weird. You have to aim them in advance. Ooh, actually, wow, that's the first time I ever did that. Okay, we should push ahead. At the very end, we see this, turrets. We have to get rid of every single turret. How do I remember this game? I haven't played this in like 20 years. And then go to the slot. Perfect. Now I do remember you can call support vehicles. You can call support vehicles, but I forgot a button combo for that. Okay, you hold A and B, but A and B simultaneously, and you have a limited amount of them, as shown in the lower right. Okay, 2-for-1. This D-pad is making my thumb hurt bad. Okay, I'm actually gonna get surrounded by these tanks. Oh, the tanks actually explode when you hit them. I assume they are remote controlled and no actual person is in them. So I do remember there is a sport called combat where people pretend to be in war and then they actually have weapons that hurt but not actually injure. Okay, come on, go. Let's not get hit by that silly UFO thing. Now, I remember this UFO can actually capture your vehicles that you call in. Excellent. Oh, let's get out of here. Beautiful. Okay, I remember one more attack type, and that's the beam. You can actually capture other vehicles for your own use, and it works through walls. Come on, let me call them. Oops. Okay, I got these. I called in the helicopter for some reason, and the helicopter got destroyed immediately. Okay. Oh, that was a lucky shot. Okay, I'm actually getting pretty bored now. Next. These games don't hold up today. But the last game I'm probably gonna be demonstrating is... Where's that helicopter game? Oh yeah, there it is. Now this is once raid on Bungling Bay, and I never beat this game. So you play as this helicopter pilot, and you're supposed to go somewhere and oh man, this controls worse than I remember. You're supposed to raid the bay and find this find the factories basically and destroy them. Okay, let's see. There it is. Okay, slow. Excellent. Okay, so we have to go down and land back in the aircraft carrier to refuel or reload our bombs. And what's the button to actually land? Okay, let's go. Oh, well, come on, I need every single bomb. Now, as a kid, I never actually figured out this game. It wasn't until I saw someone LP it on YouTube that it all made sense. Now this country is actually pretty dynamic. If the more you destroy, the more they'll actually develop technology to actually stop you. Okay, stop, slow. That tank is ramping up my style. And this is actually before the age of health bars. If you notice the D number right there, that's the amount of damage your helicopter has taken. If that reaches to 100, your helicopter just explodes. Nope, it was not enough bombs. Oh, those things are terrifying! They make such a horrible sound because it's pretty fitting on what they actually do. They're so hard to actually shoot down. Okay, slow down. Yeah, you also have to protect this aircraft carrier. And my goodness, it's really hard to protect it once those jet fighters actually populate. Excellent. Where's that factory we were bombing? It was around here somewhere. Those jet fighters are pretty terrifying. Where is that factory? Gotta be here somewhere. Aha, there it is. Stop. Ooh, yeah, I finally shot down a jet fighter for the first time in like 20 years. Excellent. Okay, let's get rid of that jet fighter before it takes off. Now, it says special. I'm not sure what that does. And an aircraft carrier has turned red. Well, I don't feel any more special. Come on, let's move. Yeah, trying to get rid of those tanks. Trying to get rid of the turrets, I mean. Stop. Ooh, that hurts. Wait, they dumped a lot of bombs into that factory that didn't explode. How convenient that the aircraft carrier is right here. Excellent. Oh, finally I shot down an jet fighter. Excellent. I'm not sure what was captivating about this game when I was a kid. I never actually even beat a single level. Now let's go see if I can actually beat one. Aha! Factory detected. Oh crap! Okay, we have to return back to our base. So that alert means that jet fighters are probably circling our base and our aircraft carrier is taking damage. We have to get rid of that thing! Oh, lucky shot! 2 bullets, 2 jet fighters. That doesn't happen very often. Okay, let's go, ow! No, we took damage! Oh, we were not able to make it back to our base. Don't worry, we have 3 lives, we can do this. So when you die, you actually respawn back in the aircraft carrier. However, if the aircraft carrier is destroyed and then you die, that's pretty much game over. Instantly, even if you have spare lives left. So defending that aircraft carrier becomes really important. Ow, what the heck? Did that just spawn in my face? Oh, come on! I haven't even had FaceTime with this factory yet. Holy crap, am I actually playing this Power Player game seriously? Okay, excellent. Excellent. Okay, now let's get some FaceTime with this factory. Now, the more factories you destroy, the more they'll start to throw at you. Oh man! Look, I just want to complete a single level. Coming in for a landing. Okay, let's get out of here. I'm actually taking a slight bit of damage from those gunboats. Now, those boats actually carry resources from factory to factory, from what I've read. Yeah, I read up on this game. Because, I read up on this game a couple years ago because, I never actually beat it as a kid. Excellent. Okay, let's go back to the aircraft carrier. Okay, we have 2 factories left, and I'm pretty sure they're gonna be throwing everything at us. Okay, there's one. Factory detected. Excellent. Yeah, don't touch me. Okay, I have to go back down there. Come on. You have to destroy those factories, mate. Ow, that hurts. Ow, that hurts. Okay, 1 more factory left. I'm gonna go come in for a landing to repair my debt. No, don't actually bomb the aircraft carrier. You can actually destroy your own aircraft carrier from what I've seen. But let's not do that. Let's see. Where is the last factory? Okay, here's the airstrip. There's the last factory. Oh, that's not nice. Ooh, come on! They're really defending this last factory, aren't they? Come on! It's like trying to swat a fly! No, 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 I got hit by that anti-aircraft thing that just spawned right in my face. Darn, that sucks. Okay, one more factory, and I got two helicopters left. Surely I can win this. It really doesn't help that the controller is not very good, but I just want to finish this, because if I actually clear this level, it will be a first time in my entire life that I actually cleared a level in Raid of Bungling Bay. No! Whoa, that thing just spawned right in my face! Now, the factories do produce those turrets, so it's... Come on, come on, let's drop or load. Okay. No, I took damage. They're really defending that factory, holy crap. I did damage it, but I'm not sure if this game is sophisticated enough to actually carry damage from previous attempts. Okay. What the heck? Okay, it's really important that we get those jet fighters off my base. I wish this helicopter had a machine gun instead of like a single cannon. No, I missed. Lucky shot. Okay, let's find that last factory. This is back in the day where there's no map, too. Okay, just gotta be careful of stuff spawning in. Okay, where is that last factory? Holy crap. I'm getting pretty popular. A lot of people are messaging me today. There it is! Okay, our first objective is to clear out the additionals. And clear this settle- Ooh, that hurts! Yeah, I think the satellite array kind of calls in here. And it's back. Oh man, I'm critical damage. Come on, come on, come on, give me the solid amount of time to destroy this factory! I'm out of bombs! Okay, my helicopter is pretty crippled, I can't move fast. Come on, I just need to... A few more bombs on that factory and I shall have won. Okay, one more jet fighter. No, it sunk! Okay, so from what I remember, there is a secret, there's a secret landing pad here. I think it's this Brotherbund logo. It only offers partial repair, so I'm guessing these are like rebels from the enemy. Okay, it doesn't actually do full repair. Okay, I just have to find that last factory and then destroy it, and they've won. Unfortunately, the factory. No! Oh, this is a loss. And with no aircraft carrier and no lives, it was a game over. I was so close to actually achieving something I've not done in my childhood, yet it was not enough. Oh well. Okay, I'm actually just curious now. I want to see what's inside this thing, so I'm gonna go take a screwdriver to it and see what's inside. Normally I won't actually do this, but I'm just curious enough. Oh no, I destroyed the sticker seal. So I noticed that this one has a cartridge slot, which my actual power player did not have. Let's see. So I'm guessing this was an earlier revision, or maybe it's an earlier version with a cartridge slot, or maybe it was a different version with cartridge slot. The one that I got in Southeast Asia did not have a cartridge slot. But then again, why would you need a cartridge slot when you have like 76,000 games? Okay. I really do hope I don't break this. Okay, here it comes. A piece of styrofoam. Beautiful. Okay, I can see now. So this transistor and resistor and a Z-inner diode regulates the voltage that's coming in. Let's see. Okay, I see it. Now the actual brains of the console is right here. Aha! We found it. So underneath right here is a capacitor that probably stabilizes the voltage coming into the coming into this motherboard, and right here is a flash chip. Now this flash chip is actually where the games are stored, and this one is a crystal oscillator. That way, it gives the actual NES hardware a clock to synchronize its components into. This one actually looks much more advanced than I. Oh, I see now. I see a date code. 2004. So this console is from 2004, 9/11. I'm not sure, year, month, day? What is 9? January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September. September 11, 2004. Holy crap, holy, September 11. This was 3 years after that devastating attack on the United States. Okay, so back here we can see a glob top. Now this actually is all of the NES hardware crammed into a small chip, smaller than a fingernail. And for cost reduction, they just stick the silicon die directly on the circuit board and then cover it with epoxy. As you can see, all the connections go straight to this chip. This does all the graphics, the sound, and the gameplay. Kind of impressive that they managed to cram an entire NES console into that, but you know, that's how technology is for you. Now today, modern pirate consoles like this probably run Linux or Android, and it's actually reused smartphone CPUs and SoCs. Makes them a lot more boring now. You know, computing power has become so prevalent and so easy to produce. I really hope you guys enjoyed this look at the power player, and like always, I'll see you guys next time. And if I find more pirate consoles like this, I'll definitely try to take a video of it and preserve it for future generations, because these kind of clone consoles or reverse engineered pirated consoles are dying out pretty fast.